in 1961, a group of artists and sort of underground filmmakers just got together and started screening films in their backyard in the East Bay and called that Canyon Cinema.
Canyon began in 1960-61 primarily as an exhibition venue and also a news source. In the early days, the late 50s, early 60s, Chick Strand started what was called the Cinema News, which was it's essentially a zine. Filmmakers would write in and then they could share news about upcoming screenings or their new films and whatnot. And that eventually kind of evolved into a screening series in Bruce Bailey, our founding father's backyard in Canyon, California, recognizing that there was a need for the greater community to have access to this material, and they started their own distribution company.
They kind of identified themselves as the underground cinema or independent cinema, avant-garde cinema, a kind of fiercely independent movement of filmmakers outside of the Hollywood mainstream and whose work demanded exhibition and distribution networks that existed outside of the theaters and this new kind of artist filmmaking movement in the 1960s in the US, and soon began growing a collection of films that were in distribution here in San Francisco from filmmakers not just on the West Coast but all over the world who wanted to make their films available to screen. And so in this spirit of cooperation, artists would join by placing copies of their films at Canyon. The collection consists of the films of, like I said, over 260 filmmakers.
So Canyon Cinema's origins are in the 60s, and the bulk of the core of the collection kind of originates with the artists that were the founding members. The oldest film actually dates back to the late 20s, and the most contemporary film is actually from 2016. The agreements are very similar now to the ones that would have been then, which is they're non-exclusive agreements. The filmmakers withhold the copyright to the work, and the prints are theirs.
It's one of very few circulating 16 millimeter film collections in existence in the world today. The spirit of an artist cooperative has always been part of the way Canyon Cinema has run. It has evolved and grown from its roots as a film distributor and is now involved in many ways in the community of film artists and in the exhibition of film. We here in San Francisco organize a screening series called the Canyon Cinema Salons, where we invite filmmakers whose work we distribute to appear in person and present their own films or to curate programs from our collection and talk about films that maybe influence them or that they particularly love.
In looking towards the future and exploring how we can engage a new generation of artists and even a long existing generation of artists that are working in alternate media, that are not just working in film. That having been said, we are completely committed to providing access to these works in their original medium for as long as is viably possible. And a big part of that is being able to have prints which are still in good condition. So, you know, we're hoping, and this is a long-term project, of which we got some grant money in support of our Canyon Cinema 50 project, which is gonna launch in 2017, to make new prints of a number of works in the collection, and while at the same time, only with filmmaker permission, digitize a number of those works as well. So, you know, we're really trying to position ourselves in a way that we can be, you know, the access point for this kind of work and allow access to it in both the ways that the filmmaker had originally intended and also for, you know, in a way for it to reach broader audiences.